Hi guys, welcome to Pydjango Tutorials. So as you know, we have last finished with our chat application built in Django. So from this video tutorial or from this video series, we'll continue or we'll start a brand new project in which we will develop that WhatsApp clone, but this time using Django REST framework and React.js. So we'll build all our APIs and basically our backend with Django REST framework, where we will set up Django channels and build our APIs for authentication, and we will sort of consume these APIs in React.js application, and we'll connect to our Django channels through Websocket in our React.js, and that's how we will proceed for this application. So as you might have seen in the YouTube or in the blogs, you cannot find these types of tutorials, and that's why I try to build things or make projects that are not that easily available, but there are guys who want to learn this and understand this, and that's the main idea and whole motive behind these kinds of series. So please guys, do support the channel as well, and please like, share and subscribe as much as you can. So it really will motivate me to make more tutorials and more videos. I know as of now I cannot, I'm not posting video regularly, or I'm not that frequent with the videos. But believe me, I'm finding or figuring out a way how I can do that. And most probably from now on, I'll try to at least post 2 to 3 videos per week, if not more. So let's continue with the very first video of this new series, that is WhatsApp clone with React.js and Django REST framework. So as of in this video, we'll simply set up our project structure and all. We won't be coding any thing in this particular video tutorial. So you can skip if you want. If you know how to set up Django REST framework and React.js, then you can skip. Otherwise, you can follow along from the very first video if you want. That's totally up to you. You can fast forward the video as well if you don't want to see all these configurations and all. Also, let me tell you that while you're watching this video, I'm assuming that you have some knowledge of Django REST framework and how Django APIs are made. Also, if you you have some knowledge about how React.js work and what is React.js. This is not a React.js tutorial, so I won't be covering everything up in React.js from beginner level. I will explain what I'm doing in the React.js application, but at very minimal level, I'll explain them. Also, we are not using any advanced libraries such as Redux. We'll try to keep our project simple as of now, and basically the whole motive behind this series is that you get to learn how you can set up things with React.js and how backend and front-end sort of communicate, whether it's a chat application or simple synchronous application. So let's start with that. So this is, I have my folder, React.js chat app, so I'll create one extra folder here. And I'll name it chat app backend, and I'll create one more folder. I'll name it chat app frontend. So as the name suggests, this folder will contain all the stuff related to Django, that is our backend, and this folder will contain all the stuff related to a frontend, that is React.js. So let's move into this and open CMD here. And we'll do django-admin start project, and we'll name it we can name it backend simply, and you can see this folder is created. Now we can open this in our Visual Studio. So this is our folder, and similar thing we can do here as well, and we can do npm
create React app. You can use create React app or any other package for creating your React application. But as of now, I'll just do the basic configuration and use npm create React app. And I'll name it to frontend simple. It's actually npx. It's not npm, it's npx create React app. So by the time our application finishes, this create React app will take some time to set up our project and install all the dependencies that are needed. So basically everything from React, React DOM, React scripts will be installed. So this will install basically all the basic things you require to run a React application. So let's give it a time and I'll fast forward the video, and as soon as this is done, I'll get back to you. So our React installation or our React project is set up. So we can do code dot to open this folder in Visual Studio. Okay. And you can see inside our frontend folder, all the necessary node modules and public folder, SRC. These all things are done. So as you know, with React.js, we usually create single page applications. So there will be only one HTML file, and we will dynamically change the DOM for this HTML file. So that's the basic, at very basic level, that's how React works. So that's why we call React works with a virtual DOM. So I will not go into detail, but you can obviously check out their official documentation to learn more. So as of now, the project is set up. Now we need some packages or some libraries in our backend. So let's go that, and I'll create one virtual environment. So I'll be using conda for that. So I'll do conda create python n. I'll name it chat app, and you can also mention the Python version that you want to install, but I'll just go with the default. So I'll just do this, and conda will create a virtual environment for us. And now all I have to do is do conda activate app. So as you can see, with this you can identify that your virtual environment is activated. So the packages we need are, we can do pip install Django, Django REST framework or something. Let me just copy this from pip install REST framework. So this is basically pip install REST framework. Okay. Or let me just copy this. Okay, these are already installed. That's good. Now I can do same thing for Django channels. This is the version. So as you know, Django channels version 4 has been released. Also, in like I have seen in the comments of my WhatsApp clone, that many of you are facing problem with setting up new channel version. So in this, we are using the latest version only, and I'll show you how you can configure or set up new channels version on your system, especially if you are on Windows PC like me, because channels need Redis layer to communicate, and Windows actually does not officially support Redis. So what we will do, we will install a Linux subsystem in our Windows,
And in that subsystem, we will run our Redis on our local host. Because even though Redis will be running on Linux subsystem localhost, but the localhost remains same for the entire environment. And that's how we will set up Redis for channels. So basic channels configuration we'll do in the next part. So we'll install it for now. So pip install channels. This is also installed. Okay, let me do one thing. Please. Okay, so these I already have. Okay, so most of the things that I need, I already have. Django is also 4.0.6. So everything is seems to be up to date. So I don't have to install anything because these things are already installed. So I'll just proceed with the code now only. So that's it for this video. In the next video, we will configure or set up our channels, and that after that, we will proceed with the further tutorials and setting up our authentication system and setting up our UI basically. And also guys, for the most part, or for the UI part, I will depend a lot on Material UI. If you guys want to sort of contribute to this project, you can come up with a UI design that will look good, and you can create your UI as well. Just I'll post the GitHub link and just submit the pull request there if you want to contribute. But I'll depend a lot on Material UI. So in the next video, we'll install Material UI as well to our React application. And I won't be focusing that much on UI as of now. So we'll just use the inbuilt libraries or take help from the libraries available. So that's all for this video. Thank you so much for watching. And please, guys, do like, share, and subscribe. It will be a great help. Thank you so much.